Alright, hello everyone, welcome back to my Modern Warfare 3 Spec Ops playthrough. We're doing Flood the Market, the second to last mission in the Spec Ops here. And here I like to clear out everybody with the grenade launcher just because it makes it easier. You can refill your ammo later so it's not like you're wasting ammo or anything. Although here I have trouble with this guy. Don't know how he hasn't died yet. Got two of them there. As you can see, I did not do too well with the grenade launcher in that instance. There was one time I actually did a lot better with it. I got, like, everybody. But, that time I did not beat the level, so you won't see it. Get the grenade to blow up in here. It's just like every other Spec Ops. Just take your time, poke your head out, kill some people, put your head back where it was, and then repeat. And don't die. So there's a bunch of people here, just wait until you're sure that there's nobody left. Which looks like that's this instance, but there's usually guys off to the right here, in the, behind the pillars, but maybe not this time. But there are dogs coming at this point, so watch out for the dogs. So you can hear them barking. There's two of them. And besides the end, the dogs are probably the hardest part. And again, it's just, at this spot, just take out everybody and just be patient about it. It'll take you a couple minutes if you're smart, like me. If you try to rush it, you'll probably die. But again, just take your time. Is really the best advice for pretty much all the Spec Ops missions, is take your time. Also, I found these Spec Ops missions to be a lot easier than the Modern Warfare 2 Spec Ops missions. Because I still have never beat all of the Spec Ops for that. But, you know, within, what, 2 months of this game being out, I have beaten all the Spec Ops, so that's good. So then once everybody's cleared out, but not everybody's cleared out because I heard a grenade, so where are they? There he is. And here you get to refill your ammo, so do it. I was doing this one, I just watched a video on this one, just for a little bit of help, because I'd played this already like 20 times, because it's fairly tough one. And so they had mentioned that sometimes people come from these stairs down here, so I kept looking. But I mean, maybe it's just a really rare occasion or something, because I never ever had it happen. So then you move forward and you trigger some guys, take them out with a grenade launcher, and that was a terrible shot. Another terrible shot. There we go. So, once again, just take your time, take out everybody, make sure everybody is dead, and then once they are, you can move on. And then you go and collect all the, whatever is in the trading floor. Oh, I'm dying. And again, I was convinced that somebody would come from down there, because they said it happens sometimes. But I never had it happen. And refill your ammo. Oh, codes, that's what you're getting from the trading floor. Got those two guys. I don't think ROM works with the grenade launcher, which kind of sucks. I wish it would. I think one more guy is in there, maybe two. Oh, there's a lot more than two. But I think that might be it. So I run forward. Go grab the codes. Now you want to grab the code closest to the stairs last. So sometimes it'll be the one in the middle, sometimes it'll actually be the one on the right, but in this instance it's the one in the middle. So it's always random where the codes are. So you want to be as close to the stairs as possible, because here what I like to do is just ignore the guys that are about to shoot at you and just run up the stairs. Although, like, nobody was shooting at me, which is really weird. It took them a while to get in here. That was a first for me. They were usually shooting me a lot. Then once you get up here, they... Like, I learned the hard way, they do continue to chase after you. So once that just about killed me, but, I was lucky that time. But after that, I always just laid down here and let them come up the ladder. And they're easy pickings. You just have to wait a little bit. And there's probably like five guys, maybe? Let's count them as they come up the ladder. Oh yeah, I tried throwing a grenade and it don't know how that happened. So is that three, four? I kind of just stopped the commentary for a second there, so that's why I'm lost to how many that is. So five, maybe? Maybe six? I may have lost one in between recordings here. I don't know. But anyway, that's how many there are, and then you come up here, and this is the hard part. So they're going to be shooting at you a lot from the other side. So right now, I would just ignore them. Just find cover. Work your way towards that tower, like in the campaign. Flash banging does not work. They're too far away. So then come over here and get yourself prone right here. What I like to do is take this barrette and just basically farm points, XP, because there is an unlimited supply of guys and a barrette with, you know, see, it's 66 plus how big is the clip? I don't know, but that's basically like, you know, over 70 times 100 XP if you hit it with every shot. Yeah, it's 7,000. So that's quite a lot of XP. And that's assuming you never miss, which with the Brett you won't miss a lot. But you'll, I mean, unless you're good, unlike me, you'll miss a lot. So if you are like me, then you'll miss a lot, is what I'm trying to say. And when the helicopter comes, just turn around and take them all out. Looks like I might have one guy left here that I can't seem to kill. Oh, there he is. He's dead. Then turn back around. And they will just keep coming and, you know, don't miss like that and waste bullets. So again, you can just, I mean, you know, one shot, one kill, and you can get a lot of points from this. Although for me, it's like averaging two or three shots per kill. So I'm seriously just gonna sit here until I run out of bullets. So I apologize for that because that makes it last a lot longer. But I wanted the points. I could have edited it out. Gosh, that's a terrible thing to say. Edited it. It's like edited three times in a row. There's nobody there. So you don't have to do this, but I like to do it just to get, you know, as much XP as I can. We're down to, it looks like there's a 10 bullet clip, so 21 bullets. course, these guys have uncanny aim for, you know, using assault rifles from across the way. I mean, these are some long shots, and they're able to hit me with, like, a M4 or an AK-47 or whatever? I don't think so. Not as often, anyway, as they do. And that's it, so then I decided to, I did not want to pick that up, actually. Well, I did, but I just wanted to replace it with the sniper rifle. So now I got both this and the XM25 or whatever it's called. So you want that because coming up here is going to be a helicopter. And you're going to use that to take out the helicopter. So what I learned from that video, which the only thing I need to know, is that it's proximity based. So it only stops downloading if you are uploading, I guess, if you get too far away, which was very useful information. And I was able to use it to... Oh, missed there, but got there. And I got hit by a mortar, which drops a gas on you. So when that happens, you have to move spots. Because you can't just sit there and gas. So that's basically it from here on out. It's just find a spot to hide. And then when you get hit by a mortar and the gas starts pulling out, move spots. It's really as simple as that. So I get hit with a mortar, move over here, so I can't get shot, and I'm not in the gas, and that works perfectly. So that's, man, that's basically the whole, this part, just stay in cover and don't get shot. I don't know if this is the way it was meant to be played, but that's how I played it and made it really quite easy, actually. And then once it uploads, I think that's it. I don't think there's anything else you have to do. So this part seems hard at first, but really isn't all that bad. And that's it. That is that mission. Just one more left, so I want to thank you all for watching, and I will see you all next time.